She says, the entire community in Medina was sad for her. She became known as Ayyimul Arab. Ayyimul Arab means the widow of all the Arabs. They felt for her. That's one of the titles they gave her. Everyone felt like a child in her presence, wanting her to be happy. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq went and proposed to her. Abu Bakr, she refused. She didn't feel right. Umar went to propose to her. She refused. And then, what happened? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and proposed to her. She then said something. Now this speaks of her mind, how clear she was, and how she knew herself. She went through a lot. She was from a noble clan and tribe. She was from such a father who everyone loved and everyone knew. And she was not concerned about what others would say. She saw the truth for what it was and stuck to the truth. Even when she had to leave Makkah for Abyssinia the first time, can you imagine going to Africa? After she came out of, she was most likely pampered. If her father was so generous with other travelers, don't you think he would have been generous with her, his daughter? She left all that for the haqq. And now she lost her husband, all. But so she knew who she was. And you know how she was determined to go travel to Medina on her own. But Allah sent the gentleman to help her, Uthman ibn Talha. Here the Nabi Muhammad وسلم, proposes to her. She doesn't just accept, she first says, Ya Rasulullah, there's three things about me you must know. What? She says, Ana ma'atun shadidatul ghira. I'm a woman that's very jealous. And I fear that you will see something from me and it might upset you. And as a result, Allah will punish me. Number one. Number two, وَأَنَا مْرَأَةٌ قَدْ دَخَلْتُ فِي السِّنِ. And I am a woman that has aged. Right? In one text I found that she was born about 28 years before the Hijrah. You have to work it out, but she was over 30. She was almost maybe over, just over 40. They say by this time in the fourth year, she was about 42. So she said, I have entered into old age. And number three, I am a woman with children. Fakeness. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as for what you say regarding your jealousy, I will pray to Allah that He eases it for you, makes it lighter for you. Right? Number one. Number two, as for what you say regarding age, I'm in the same boat. He says, what has come to you has already come to me, the Rasul said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at the time, if it was the fourth year, so he was 57. Yeah, 56, 57. As for what you say regarding your children, look what he says. He says, فَإِنَّمَا عِيَالُكِ عِيَالِي. Know that your children are mine. Sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Zainab bint Khuzaymah, one of the other wives of Rasulullah, had just passed on, like a few months before that. So Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi married Salamah, who had lost everything before. At the time she was without a child and a husband, then regained a child, and then a husband, then lost her husband. And now she became a mother to the entire ummah of Muslimun. Because Allah says in the Quran, وَأَزْوَاجُهُ أُمَّهَاتُهُمْ. And his wives, the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's wives, are the mothers of the ummah. Nah. And her mahr, they say, all that she wanted was a mattress, firashun, hashwuhu leaf, like a mattress that was filled with some leaves, like straw, waqidrun, and a pot, wasahifatun, a nice plate, and then some additional things, some pieces of garments. That was it. Nothing too grand. But now what we know of her is this, a few things. Alright. There's still time, just stay with me. There's a famous hadith, the end of which has different narrations. Now, I don't know, some of you might have heard of this hadith. The ayah in Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah speaks about Ahlul Bayt, The literally Ahlul Bayt means the family of the house. Now this whole discussion as to who are the Ahlul Bayt. Are the wives of Rasulullah included? Or are they only a numbered few? Are they only Sayyidah Fatima radhiallahu anha, Ali radhiallahu anhu, and Hassan and Hussein? Some say it's only them, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the fifth. Because he did something, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once, he took his shawl and he called them Ali, Fatima, Hassan and Hussein radhiallahu anhum, and he covered them and he said, Rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu alaykum ahlul bayt. Allahumma inna ha'ulai ahlul bayti. He said, the mercy of Allah and His blessings be on you, O the people of the house. And then he says, O Allah, verily these are the people of my house. Okay? But there are other narrations that you said things like what? Salman. When Salman, al-Farisi, who had no ties to any of the Arabs, he was from Persian lands. At the time when Rasulullah ﷺ formed a brotherhood between the Muhajirin and Ansar, he stood in the middle because he wasn't linked to any. So Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Salmanu minna ahlul bayt. Salman is from us, the people of my house. So the term was sometimes specific and the term was sometimes a bit more general. But anyway, there's one narration where it was actually in her space, in her house, the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was sitting and Hassan and Hussein was there and he called them and hugged them. He hugged them. And then he called Ali and Fatima and he did that with the shawl. And she heard Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying what he said and she began to cry, Umm Salamah. And when Rasulullah saw her crying, he asked, Mayub Kiki, what is causing you to cry? Mayub Kiki, what causes you to cry? And she said, قَدْ خَصَصْتَهُمْ نَعْمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ خَصَصْتَهُمْ وَتَرَقْتَنِي وَابْنَتِي. She had a daughter, Zainab, there. She said, Ya Rasulullah, you have specified them and you have left me and my daughter. Nabi Sallallahu then said, أَنْتِ وَابْنَتِكْ أنت وابنتك من أهل البيت. You and your daughter are from the family of the house too. In other narration, he added and said, مكانك وأنت في خير. You are in your place and you are in a lot of good. You are in a good place. Okay? But that's significant regarding it was in her house. You know, amongst the female Sahabiyat, who narrates the most ahadith? Sayyidah Aisha radhiallahu anha. And who, after her, narrates the most? Umm Salama. And Umm Salama, the Sahabiya we are dealing with, just to show her determination, she was of the elders of the wives. And how we know that? Sayyidah Aisha radhiallahu anha says, Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if there was nothing urgent to see to after Asr, he would have a habit of visiting all of us. He would pop in by all his wives, who all were there at the time, check if they need anything. If they wanted anything, anyone wants to say anything, would pop in and just briefly. But it would start by Umm Salama because Aisha says, she was our senior. And it would end by me, I was the youngest. But now, what is important is this. Aisha was the youngest, so you understand, and some people say, that's one of the wisdoms behind Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam marrying her. Because she was young, she could absorb, and that's why she narrates most of the ahadith. Isn't it? Lots. And fiqh and things of the senior Sahaba even. Abu Huraira them all and others and Tabi'un used to go learn by her. She gave fatwa as well, Sayyidah Aisha. But here we have the one who narrates the second most is not the one who was maybe just a bit older than her. Nay, the oldest of the wives. Isn't that something? So determination. And more than that, lots, they say, Laja'a kathiru min as-sahaba indaha. It's as if after the demise of Rasulullah ﷺ, along with Sayyidah Aisha, she had her own times when big Sahaba used to come and question and ask her and give it draw advice and gain direction. And so many, this list of over 50 Sahaba and later on Tabi'un, because something else I'll tell you, something significant regarding her, all narrate from her. Right? What Imam Bukhari and Muslim alone have agreed upon in their narrations of 378 ahadith. Yeah. And most of her riwayat of ahadith were regarding the laws, the ahkam of tahara, the ahkam of salah, the ahkam of hajj, the laws of zakah, and she narrated lots of ahadith regarding etiquette and mannerisms.